In this video, I'm going to show you how we can use pop-up feature in Excel. I'm sure many of you are not using this feature, but it is very useful. We have a data range here, which has city and their country. On the right hand side, I have created a table. When we enter any city under city column, it should pick up the country automatically. But if we enter any city name, which is not there in the data range, it should give us a pop-up window saying, please enter valid city name. To do that, first we will use VLOOKUP function to get the country based on the city. So we'll type VLOOKUP. So the lookup value will be whatever we are going to enter in this city called cell. Table array, we'll select the city and the columns here. For column index, the column index will be 2 as we need the country based on the city. Range lookup will keep it as 0. Close the bracket and press enter. So if it is blank, it is giving me some error. So to fix that, we'll use if error function. If there is an error, we'll keep it as blank. Close the bracket and press enter. So let's enter the city here to see whether the country automatically gets picked up. So we'll enter Bombay, and if you press enter, we'll get the country as India. If I enter Moscow, the country is Russia. Let's try one more, Tokyo, and the country is Japan. Suppose if I enter any city which is not there in the data range, so it will be blank, but I need a pop-up here. So to get the pop-up, we'll have to go to VBA code. So we'll right click on the sheet, click on view code. To create a pop-up, right click and click on insert module. So we'll get the module here. In the module, we are going to type a function. So I'll type function, and the name of the function. So I'm just going to enter pop-up one. You can type the name as per your requirement and press enter. Here we will give the message. So the message should be in a message box. We're going to type message box over here. Space. And in double quotes, you're going to write your message. So here we are going to type please enter valid city name. So that will be the pop-up window which will pop up whenever we are entering any of the city which is not available in the data range. So press Ctrl S to save it and close. Now in the formula, we'll have to make some changes. So if error, instead of blank, we'll type here the function name which we have created in the VBA code. So that will be pop-up 1. Let's tap, close the bracket and press enter. So you'll see you get the pop-up as please enter valid city name. Let's try to put another city here. If I put Istanbul, I'll get the country name as Turkey. But so if I enter any of the city which is not available in the data range, it will give me a pop-up, please enter valid city name. And you click on OK. So whenever you type a city name which is not available, it will give you a pop-up window over here saying please enter valid city name. And if you enter any of the city name here which is available, it will give you the country name. So that is how it works. Let's try one more example. So I've got another sheet here, sheet 2. We'll type a formula over here. I'll select the range as column B. Criteria will be in the name. And sum range will be the amount column. So if I enter A, I'll get the total of A in this cell. If I type C, I'll get the total of C. If I get type T, I'll get the total of T in the amount cell. But if I type any of the text or any of the letter which is not there in the name column, I should get a pop-up over here. So suppose I type E, it gives me 0. So instead of that, I should get a pop-up here. So again, let's go to the view code, go to module. I'll add one more function over here. Popup 2, message box, please enter valid name. So you can keep creating the functions for the pop-up whatever you want. In the VBA code, save it and close it. So to get the pop-up over here, we'll type the formula here equal to if G2 cell, that is for the amount, is equal to 0, we should get the pop-up 2. And press enter. So if I'm typing E, which is not available in the name column, it will give me a pop-up saying please enter valid name. If I type A, it will give me the proper calculation which we have done in this formula. So if the value is correct, we are getting false here. To fix this, we'll add a double quotes over here at the end. And press enter. So if the value is correct, you won't get any false value over here. Suppose I type C, I'll get the proper calculation which is there in the formula. Now if I type any of the letter which is not available in the name column, say R, it will give me a pop-up window saying please enter valid name and press OK. We have written a formula here and this is also showing as 0. To fix this, what we can do is we can select this cell and give the color as white for the text. Now if I type D, it will give me the value. If I type G and press enter, it will give me a pop-up window saying please enter valid name. And if you press OK, there will be no value over here and you'll get 0 over here. So this is how you can use the pop-up formula or the pop-up feature which is available in the cell.